Hello, my name is Remy Turner. I'm a senior and I would like to welcome you all to the 2021 Multicultural Assembly. Let's begin as we always do when we gather with prayer. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. Now other students will repeat this phrase in different languages before we proceed.
Ricordiamoci che siamo alla santa presenza di Dio. San Giovanni Battista della Sale, prega per noi. Vivi Gesù nei nostri cuori, per sempre.
Recordemos que estamos en la santa presencia de nuestro Señor. San Juan Bautista de la Salle, ruega por nosotros. Que viva Jesús en nuestros corazones, ahora y siempre.
Good and gracious God, you created all people in your image. We thank you for the amazing variety of races and cultures in this world. Enrich our lives by ever-widening circles of friendship and show us your presence in those who differ most from us. Until our knowledge of your love is made perfect in our love for all of your people. St. John Baptist de la Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. So next up is Miss Cruz, who is a junior high Spanish teacher here at CBA, and she will be speaking about her heritage and culture.
Hello, everyone. My name is Yvette Cruz Barceau. I teach Spanish here at CBA, and I would like to share with you some information about the Cuban educational system and how it compares with the United States. Many of the basic things are similar. Cuban classrooms are organized very much like American classrooms, and students are required to attend school at least until ninth grade. While most American students study Spanish, Cuban students more often study English as a second language. It is important to mention that in Cuba, there's only public education. No private options exist. In the United States, uniforms are most common at private schools, whereas Cuban schools require students to wear them until college. Education is very highly valued in Cuban culture, perhaps because it is a poor country and many material things are hard to access. Knowledge is prioritized and becomes his own currency. Because education is free and access to the arts is cheap, Cubans have access to many cultural experiences to learn from. One big difference is the role of sports. Athletics are culturally important, like in the US. Baseball is our national sport. However, sports are not emphasized so heavily in schools. Unlike the US, where students athletes can receive athletic scholarships at most universities, Cuba has specific athletic colleges that are only for students pursuing a career in sports. For example, a student couldn't attend University of Havana on a baseball scholarship. They have to go to a different college to pursue an athletic career. Because universities are free, students don't have to worry about having student loans, and universities don't have to worry about earning tuition money because they're funded by the government. The fact that finances don't play a role in choosing a school changes the whole process. In the United States, especially during COVID, technology, we can see, is a huge part of the student experience. Cuban schools do not have much technology to support learning or teaching. Many students don't have access to calculators or computers. And at school, internet access is very limited and computers are shared by many students in a lot of schools. Having a computer at home is unusual, and internet access is also very limited across the country. And for the ones that can afford it, is very expensive and not reliable. The lack of digital infrastructure can create challenges, especially during a pandemic, because remote learning is like nearly impossible in Cuba. The Cuban government decided to delay the start of the school year following the coronavirus outbreak. I think the school year last year it started in November or December instead of September as a regular year. Overall, Cuba has a lot of problems. It is a poor country and can be a difficult place to live. Because Cuba has an authoritarian government and is very isolated, it is an island also. It was very hard for me to find reliable statistical comparisons between its education system and those of other countries. But I found in my experience, when I came to the United States and entered the master's program in linguistics at SU, that I felt extremely well prepared. And I know many Cubans who have had the same experience after leaving to study outside the country. So what I can share today with you is that in my own experience, education was one of the best things about growing up there.
No fighting. Shakira, Shakira. I never really knew that she could dance like this. Hey. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Sí. Bonita. Sí. Picasa. Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. Hey. So be wise sí. And keep on hey. Reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie. And I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. Baby, this is perfection.
Hey girl, I can see your body moving, and it's driving me crazy. And I didn't have the slightest idea until I saw you dancing. And when you walk up on the dance floor, nobody can add it all. The way you move your body, girl. And everything's so unexpected, the way you right and left it. So you could keep on shaking it.
I never really knew that she could dance like this.
She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama?
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad.
All right, I'm going to be teaching a few of the basic salsa moves.
and I'm going to be obviously doing female steps. So females always start with their right foot, and the first basic step is to go backwards. So then the male would take his left foot forward at the same time and come back together. Then the female would take her left leg and bring it forward as the male brought his right leg backwards. And it's all kind of a three-step march motion. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then you can do the same exact thing to the side. So females will take their right leg first, while males will take their left and go to the side, 1, 2, 3, and then the other way, 1, 2, 3. And then when you all put it together, it looks pretty smooth. And you can go faster and faster as you go. So that's it for the first basic steps of salsa. Hopefully you can try it out at home.
On ne m'a point dans ses bras, il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit tes mots d'amour, tes mots de tous les jours, et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur. Il n'est pas de bonheur, tant je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans les vies. Il me l'a dit, la j'aurai pour la vie. Give your heart and soul to me. In life will always be la vie en rose.
Hello, it's Remy. I'm a senior and I'm going to be reading a poem written by sophomore Emily Jones about her culture.
Culture is the smell of burning wood, the heat that radiates from the furnace, the pounding of feet hitting the worn wooden planks, the rhythm of drums and rattles, the emotion behind a language so familiar yet so different. Culture is a warm bowl of soup, consumed around loved ones after a long day of preparation. The crunch of biting into bread, the fluffy interior, the natural sweetness of strawberry washing down a fulfilling meal. Culture is the jagged texture of bleachers, the rough roundness of bolts, the loud crashing of sticks and bodies, the encouraging cheers of fans. Culture is comfort, a place where one belongs. Thank you, Emily.
Hello, my name is Alex Burnett. It is my pleasure to introduce CBA's combined chorus singing, Bon Say Abba. This is a song of welcoming from the nation of Zambia. When translated, it means, all who sing with the spirit have the right to be called the children of God. This song calls for a cappella and percussion. In quarantine, we've been spending a lot of time in our homes and getting invested in new projects. This month, the CBA chorus students took on making their own percussion instruments out of fruits and vegetables. It's pretty weird, but we hope it brings you a smile because we could all use one.
Pleasure to present to you Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. I am happy to join with you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. Five score years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long night of their captivity. But 100 years later, the Negro still is not free.
Americans and the world. When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? the loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. In the norms and notions of what just is, isn't always just is. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And so we lift our gaze not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. That is the promised glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare it. Because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it.
That one day, this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
How do you feel as a black student going to CBA?
Obviously, I know going to CBA totally is a privilege. I'm glad I get to represent myself and kind of the greater community going here, you know. I'm just happy I get the chance to do it.
I always been to a predominantly white school most of my life, so going to CBA wasn't even that much different. It was just more white people. So it was being surrounded by more white people, you having them to be your friends and more of that, you do see microaggressions, even if it's not intentional.
You know, just the view of the school is a bunch of rich white kids, you know. But everyone, at least in my classes, turned out to be really understanding, really capable, and really just willing to learn.
Initially, when I got to CBA, it was very much a culture shock because where I came from, there was a lot of different ethnicities, even though California may be seen as predominantly white. There were a lot of Hispanics and Samoans, blacks, whites. It was just a bigger diversity pool.
I feel good, you know. I feel that overall it's a welcoming community to go to CBA, being African American.
With current events and the events that happened over the summer, how did that affect you?
I wouldn't say it affected me. You know, I just had to work, twice as hard to, get where I am now.
Well, it obviously has raised tensions between certain groups. And I think that's something we can't really ignore. But obviously, more fighting isn't going to solve anything. So I think, as a student at CBA, our job right now should be trying to unify with one another instead of just causing more division.
What is your definition of Black Lives Matter?
It really is just a call to recognize that even in our modern societies that we don't value Black people as much as we claim to, even after all these years of fighting racism, both interpersonal and in the government policies as well.
I think BLM to me just means literally what the words say, Black Lives Matter. It's not anybody else's life doesn't matter. It's not anything more than just saying that, reinforcing the belief that Black lives do matter.
The definition of Black Lives Matter is essentially a movement that was started to spread the word and spread awareness about the terrible, terrible discrimination that happens throughout this country and all around the world, and has been happening for centuries regarding people solely based on the color of their skin.
Black Lives Matter, the best way to look at it is that it's a reminder that we're all equal, and not that one person is better than the other, just that everyone does matter, and not that one group's life should be held at a higher value than someone else.
Ways can your community be more supportive of the Black Lives Matter movement?
I think just seeing that we can all be inclusive and wanting to help one another. I think the way to end racism is to understand and listen.
I think not just being educated from Instagram. Like, if you really care for it, I think you should go and do like deeper research and not just post every like info back you see on Instagram.
And finally, how do you think you and your peers can bridge the gap of racial injustice?
I think one of the biggest ways that myself and my peers can bridge a gap between racial injustice is by first acknowledging that it happens. I feel like that's a huge problem in this country, is that people just don't seem to think that there is discrimination, or to the degree of discrimination that we all see or that others may see.
To bridge the gap, it's really a collective effort. You need everyone on board. We need to get the entire CBA community to buy into this idea that Black lives do matter, and we're going to stand by our friends and our family members and those in our community who are marginalized. And we just need to work together to bridge that gap through education, through awareness, and, you know, dismantling the barriers that separate us.
Easy. The way that we can bridge that gap is to continue, you know, being friends and getting along.
Just take a step back and look through one another's lens instead of only looking through the way we see the world now. Maybe just try to understand that there's something more than what we think or what we believe out there.
That is it for the 2021 Multicultural Assembly, so let us conclude with a closing prayer. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. First off is the reading of a Hebrew prayer by Henya Zames, which translates in English to, "Let us sing to Adonai, let us rejoice in our Creator. Let us greet God with thanksgiving, singing psalms of praise."
Lahu Neranana Ladonai Naria Latsuri Shenu Nekadma Panav Betoda Bizmiro Naria Lo.
May the God who created a world of diversity and vibrancy go with us as we embrace life in all its fullness. May the Son who teaches us to care for strangers and foreigners go with us as we try to be good neighbors in our communities. May the Spirit who breaks down our barriers and celebrates community go with us as we find the courage to create a place of welcome for all.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio, del Spirito Santo. Amen. Ricordiamoci che siamo alla Santa Presenza di Dio. San Giovanni Battista della Salle, prega per noi. E vivi Gesù nei nostri cuori per sempre. Amen. Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio, del Spirito Santo. Amen.
Ating ang lahanin ang Diyos sa ating kapiling. San Juan Bautista de la Salle, ipanalangin mo kami. Mabuhay ka, Jesus, sa aming mga puso, magpakailanman.
St. John Baptist de la Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. Thank you.